Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today's video, I'm going to talk about something that is really, really interesting for this particular time of year, and that is gift sets. If you have a lot of product laying around and you want to see the sales come rolling in, you need to start thinking about selling your products in gift sets. And in this video, I will talk about how to assemble one, the pricing, the do's and don'ts, and give you just general tips and tricks on how to do this and why this particular product is a must-have, especially with Christmas just around the corner. If you're new here, hi, my name is Jerrica. I'm the owner and creator of Quench Inc., which is a soap and bath bomb company. And on this channel, I talk all about how I sell my products and how I make my products. And if you're interested in that, then please subscribe. And now without further ado, let me talk about gift sets. First of all, why gift sets? Why would we even think about selling something like this? Gift sets are an awesome way for a range of your products to be sold all at once in one transaction and for your customers to get a bit of a sample of your brand and company, and also a way for them to easily and conveniently gift your products to somebody else. I know for me in particular, selling gift sets is one of the things that really helped boost my sales and increase the order ticket number for each customer. And this is the time of year to start thinking about grouping your products together because Christmas is just around the corner and people are definitely looking for gift sets. And you're in luck because our particular product, Bath & Body, make amazing gifts. When you're at the point of your business when you have a variety of products that you are selling, so for example, you have soaps, body butters, bath bombs, lip balms, that is about the time that you should start thinking about bundling those different products together to form a gift set. When it comes to actually assembling your gift sets together and thinking about what gift sets to sell, normally the easiest thing to do is to group complementary products together in similar scents or the same scent. Gift sets are all about convenience. The people that are buying your gift sets don't necessarily want to think too hard about what's in it. You want to make that decision as easy as possible for your customer. So that's why grouping products in the same scent together or having a very specific theme is a really great way to sell this product to your customers. You might ask yourself, should I have a gift set for all of the different fragrances that I provide to my customers in my company? The answer is no, you definitely don't want to do that. When it comes to gift sets, you want to sell only the best-selling scents or the types of scents that most people are going to gravitate towards. So for example, for my company, we have over 8 to 10 fragrances of soap. I'm not going to have a gift set for each one of those fragrances. I'm just going to have the very general ones and the ones that sell the best and the easiest. A great example is lavender. Most people love lavender, so a really easy gift set to put together that I know will sell is a lavender gift set where all of the products in that gift set are scented in lavender. Another great idea when it comes to gift sets is your best sellers. This type of gift set is a really great seller because it's a variety of your products and normally it's different scents. And you really take the thinking out of your customer's mind when they want to buy something for their friends and family or they want to sample the very best products in your company with the confidence that other people have already validated that these products are great and this is what sells the best when it comes to your company. So when it comes to my company, we have sold a bestsellers gift set that did really well, but normally we will definitely have a lavender gift set. We have a Georgian Bay gift set, which is a variety of products in our signature Georgian Bay scent. And then we also have a raspberry vanilla gift set. And that scent is a sweet, creamy scent. So it kind of covers most of what people are generally looking for. But another theme or scent profile you want to think about is a citrus type of gift set or a essential oil, all essential oil products type of gift set. Basically, the more cohesive the theme, the easier it will be for you to sell. So now that you've picked the theme of your gift set, how many products do you want to include in your gift set? I find that the magic number tends to be 3. And the reason why I want to keep my gift sets to about 3 products is because you find that there is a threshold, and this can change from brand to brand, company to company, as to the price point that people are willing to spend when it comes to gifting your products. So for us, it's around $30 worth of product value. And when it comes to our company, That usually is a body butter, a soap, and a lip balm. And having three products is also a really good idea because it keeps your gift sets light for shipping. And we all know that the lighter your orders are, the cheaper it is for you to ship out. And that is something definitely to consider. So when you start adding more and more items to your gift set and it starts to get bigger and bulkier and heavier, that is going to be added extra weight that you will have to pay for when you're shipping it out. Now, when it comes to packaging your gift sets, you absolutely want to offer a box. And it's just because when people think of gifts, they think of their gifts being contained in some sort of container. And you don't have to go fancy with your boxes, guys. I use these collapsible, I don't even know the proper term for it, but you assemble them yourselves, or like the flat boxes. And we get these from Staples and Uline, and they're made out of cardboard. I know there are fancier options out there, but if your business is small, you want to keep your costs low. And I find that these boxes are excellent. And I like that they're white too. I feel that white complements Bath and Body products really well. And when it comes to picking the size of your box, it's absolutely worth it to pick a box that your products just about fill, that isn't too small and isn't too big. And as you can see for these products, this is a 9x4x3 box, and the products in this gift set perfectly fill it out. And another reason why you want to make sure you're picking the right box is not just because of shipping purposes, but also because it provides the idea of value to your customer. If your products are in a box that's a little bit too big, they're going to be swimming in there, there's going to be a lot of empty space, and psychologically your customer might think that they're spending too much on their gift set. So you want to make sure that they feel like they're getting the value that they're paying for. When we're selling these gift sets in person, we like to have a display gift set and a gift set that's sealed and closed up like this. So when it comes to the display gift set, what we usually do is cut this piece off like this, so it's like this, and we might shrink wrap it in our national shrink wrap system so that the customers can't fiddle around with it, but they're still able to see what's inside of the gift set. And then for the ones that we're selling, they're going to be closed like this and sealed with a sticker. So that's how we like to sell it in person. And we find that when we wholesale these gift sets to our wholesale customers, they like to buy a display gift set for their purposes as well. When it comes to picking products for your gift set, it's not just about the scents. You absolutely do want a cohesive theme and possibly all similar types of scents, if not the same scents. But you also want to think about the products themselves. You want the products to complement one another. It's easy to do when you're a Bath and Body company. Most products go together regardless. But for me, I like to think about the customer at each stage of whatever type of self-care they're going through. So for example, I like to always add a soap because that is our signature product. We love the beautiful swirls of our soap, and obviously the colors are just so vibrant and beautiful. But when it comes to the other types of products, for example, our body butters and lotions, and even our candles, we like to offer a smaller version of that product. And the reason we like to do that goes back to what I said before about your gift sets being kind of like a sampler of your company. And normally when they're gifting your products to family and friends, they don't know whether or not they're gonna enjoy your products. So it's always good to provide a smaller version so that if they fall in love with your products, they can go onto your website and buy the bigger full version for themselves. For those curious, this is our body butters in a 4-ounce straight-sided jar from Uline. And you find this is a great size for putting your jarred products in for gift sets. So now that you have your products chosen, the theme or scents chosen for your gift box, and you've ordered your actual boxes and you're ready to put everything together, you should definitely consider selling these products online. So when it comes to selling these boxes online, we take tons of pictures of the products in the actual gift box and how they're going to look. And I like to have a picture of them laid out like this, how the recipient of your gift box is going to see it when they open the lid, and that's always a great shot. I also like to take pictures of the products set up kind of a little helter-skelter like this, as though the customer has already opened it and checked out their products. And I like to take pictures of the products included in the gift set grouped together outside of the box as well. So these are all shots that I go out of my way to take because I feel that those shots are the shots that people are drawn to and are the most effective in selling these gift boxes online. Another great way to sell these boxes online is to provide a little bit of choice. I know I said that the easier it is for your customer to buy this, the better when it comes to gift boxes, but adding that little bit of choice also helps. And what I mean by that is, I talked about selling body butters in a gift set, but I sell other products in jars like this. So for example, I sell lotions in jars like this and sugar scrubs in small jars like that. So what I like to do online is provide a drop-down menu where people can pick whatever product they want in the jar. And I found that that is very effective in converting customers as well, because sometimes people aren't body butter people and sometimes they're not sugar scrub people. So having that little bit of choice really helps as well. Another way to sell gift boxes is to provide personalized gift cards with each box. And this is pretty easy to do online. You can use Canva to create very simple cards, and they don't need to be fancy. They just have to have the sentiment, for example, happy birthday or Merry Christmas, and then adding somebody's name to the bottom of that, so that it's a completely personalized and custom gift set for your customer and whoever they're gifting it to. And the reason why this step really helps sell your gift sets is because this is something that they can't get just about anywhere. I mean, they can do it on Amazon, that's true, but it's nice to have that little extra touch of customization and really leaves a really great impression to your customers that you're able to offer this. And I did mention Canva as a way to do this, and you can do it very simply and quickly on there, but I like to do it on Photoshop. It's also very quick and simple to do it on there. So it's a simple matter of creating these templates. So for example, happy birthday or Merry Christmas, and just changing the name and the custom message when you can. And the way to do that on Shopify, on my website, I've added a custom box or a field box at checkout. And if people have chosen that, yes, they do want a custom message through the options that I provide, then I let them know that they have to write what they want that card to say as they check out. And there's a million ways to do this as well on Shopify, but I find that if you take the time to figure out how to do it, it really helps to make more sales. And now that I'm thinking more about it, I think this would be a really great video to do all on its own. How to customize your listings on both Etsy and Shopify. That little extra step of customizing your listings so that your customer has a little bit more control, I feel that really makes a difference when it comes to conversion. So now we come to the point that everyone wants to know is, how do I price these gift sets? Should I be offering a deal since I'm bundling products together? Should I charge more? What should I do? So what I do when it comes to a gift set is I charge what each individual item costs retail, and then I add a dollar on top of that to account for the box, the fill, and everything else that goes into a gift set. So the short answer is no, I do not provide a discount when it comes to gift sets. And the reason is because you are actually providing a service to your customer. You're making it easier for them to pick out a gift for their friend or even for themselves, and you're taking a lot of the guesswork out of the way for them. And you'll find that if you price your gift sets accordingly and it's full retail price, people are willing to pay that, because a lot of people just want to go into a website, make the purchase, and go. They don't want to sit there for a long time filling their cart with individual things, trying to figure out what their friends like or what they like, etc., etc. The easier it is that you make it on them, the better. A final piece of advice when you are assembling gift sets is to always include your card and information in the gift set itself, because if people are gifting your gift sets to their friends and family, it is a way for you to advertise your company to a whole network of people. So slipping in your card and letting whoever receives this box know where to find you definitely leads to future sales. And what I like to do is to add a little bit of a discount code, which adds that little bit of extra push for whoever receives this box to purchase from you and possibly gift your stuff to their friends or buy more stuff for themselves. So not only am I including my business card and an information card and another card, like possibly a thank you card, in with these gift sets, I'm also branding this part of the box here. We usually add stickers that say our brand and a message on here, but you can also use stamps don't waste the space over here. This is all really good advertising space as well. And think about whoever receives this box, what they're going to see when they open it, and you want to make that experience as pleasant and amazing as possible. And I used to work for Apple Corporate, and this is the type of stuff that they agonize and spent tons of hours on, is just the experience the customer gets when opening their product. Just because you're a small business and just starting doesn't mean you don't have to think like a big company. So that's it. I really hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, please leave it a huge thumbs up. And if you want to know where to buy my products, I have that linked down below. And if you want to know how I make my products, I have a lot of recipes on my Patreon, and that is linked in my description as well. And speaking of my Patreon, thank you to everybody who has chosen to support us on there. Every little bit helps. So I'm so grateful and so thankful to you guys, especially these people over here, my bubble BFFs. A few of them are business owners themselves, and I've linked a few of their amazing businesses in my description box below. Please check them out. And that's it. If you enjoyed watching this kind of video, please subscribe. And until the next one, keep smiling, keep being awesome, keep creating gorgeous, beautiful, wonderful things. And I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.